Well, good morning and welcome back. We're in Tampa for the 2020 RV Super Show, and I was fortunate enough to be able to arrange a tour for you of the Panoramic RV with Phil Marcotte, the CEO and founder. He's going to give us a tour of this beautiful, beautiful Class B surrounded by windows, and it's just a beautiful day here in Tampa and hardly a cloud in the sky. So we'll take a few minutes and talk with Phil, and then he's going to show us the features inside and out. Tell me a little bit about your background.
Well, I was always in manufacturing. I started in the manufacturing just out of university. I was manufacturing medical equipment for disabled people and aging people, and did that for many years. After that, I turned into armored truck manufacturing. I was armored trucks for Brinks and Garda, and we were one of the most advanced company manufacturing armored truck, extremely smart trucks, and we did pretty well with that. And after that, I got into the RV business. We've done a lot of vans, armored van, that were on the US market also, and it just, I don't know, it's a different animal. It's a different finish touch in an RV. But it's still the same chassis, so requirements for safety are very similar that what we have to an armored truck, except nobody is going after you with a gun.
Okay, so your background is really manufacturing vehicles and ergonomics for disabled people.
Yep.
Well, it's absolutely a beautiful unit, and I think it's very well thought out.
Maybe first thing I should tell you about the Panoramic, you know, is the one thing you will notice is the size of the windows. This is where it gets its name from. Is, you know, we have used huge window, the CRL system. You have a window in the kitchen, you have a window in the bathroom, all windows surrounding the bed. So we know our people, our customer, our people who like to see things, they like to go in parks, they like to see the nature. So we thought it would be great to see it even when you're inside the RV. So that's why we put all those windows inside. And then the second aspect of the Panoramic is the great front lounge floor plan, where you have that permanent bed. You don't need that gymnastic of setting up the beds morning and night.
Yep.
So it's always there, always ready if you want to go for a nap. And then you have that great lounge here in front near the sliding door, so which makes a great spot to hang.
Right, well, that was one of the big features that we were attracted to, the bed that lifts up in the back. that's just fantastic. And the windows, I mean, you said a CRL window. What is a CRL?
Yeah, it's a California company that makes, that they're specialized in automotive windows. So these windows are the awning style windows, so they can be open, and despite rain coming down, they can be left open.
They open from the bottom.
Yeah, and create some good ventilation in combination with the max fan. So that gives you just great breeze inside the RV without any need of putting the air conditioning on, even in a high temperature.
You can see in 360 degrees as well as up through this beautiful skylight.
Yeah, absolutely. So let me show you one of the great things about that front lounge area we have, is a very flexible area. So we have that table here that turns around. So if you want to have dinner side by side, you can do it like that, or you can do it face to face like that. It can also serve as an extra counter space, so you can swivel it around. And you also have the possibility, if you need more space while you're on the driver's seat, you can always slide that table here and have extra space there. Or if you need more space for the person here, you can always push it back. And that very same table comes with an extra set of track at the bottom, so very easily you can raise that table, you can cut the leg of the table, and then you can drop it on the other set of track. Let me do it right now. A lot of people are wondering, how long does it take to set up the bed? This is the time that it takes, and then you just take the other cushion and put it right here. So extremely easy to do. back. There you go. So this is our kitchen space. We have our stove here. A sink is here. A huge fridge here. And you have also different compartment for food, a large food pantry back there that I will show you in a minute, and a lot of storage space, but great food preparation area. Mm-hmm. Even an additional space here on the side. So here's the food galley. So we have a vertical food galley with a lot of storage space. It allows you to see what you need in a very easy way. And with that vertical food galley, we have a vertical fridge. So we eliminate the need of crawling in the bottom of the RV and trying to find food in the bottom of the fridge when you have a great vertical fridge. That is a three-way fridge, so it works on propane, 110 and 12 volt. And there's also a compressor fridge option available. And one thing that we notice, When we designed our RV, we asked a question to different chefs, you know, what do you need to make great food in an RV? And the question for a chef is often a timing question. They need to access food in a timely fashion because everything happens fast and in a kitchen, that's important. So when you have vertical fridge, vertical galley, and if you can leave everything open at the same time, that gives you an extremely good access to water, and you have your surface, so it allows for extremely nice cooking experience. Another thing that we did is that, you know, when we designed the different drawers, you notice that the drawers are similar in size. So we want to give it a very modern, a contemporary look. They are similar in size, but when you open them, you will notice that there is a big drawer and a small drawer, and this is just a facade. The reason is that we moved half of these drawers on the side here. So if most of people will put their glass or their cutlery here, so as they are setting up their picnic table on the side, sometimes they forgot a knife or a fork, so they can just come back here instead of getting up back in the van. They're saving some step and they have access to these things. And we also put probably the most important accessories of the RV, a trash can right here by the door, so it's easily accessible whether you're inside or outside the RV. So these are the controls for the lights. So you have an additional lighting system here up for ambience. You have the general central alley lights, and you have the light for the exterior under the awning. All these lights are dimmable, so we can reduce the amount of light just to create a mellow ambience at night, or we can just push them to the maximum. A very nice thing also about the light control is that they're not only at the front of the coach, but they're also at the back in the room. So when you go to bed at night, you can always close the light and you don't need to go back to the entrance of the RV to make that happen. The other nice thing about the control that we thought about the user is that the Truma control, the heating system and the water heater, is at the head of the bed. So when you wake up in the morning, you often want to crank the temperature just a few degrees and you want to start the water heater. So you don't have to wake up and get out of bed to do that. The controls are all there. If you want to open the light at night or if you're getting up, you can always access these controls and you don't have to get back to the front of the RV again. So another
That's a really, really great idea. And how about that fan? Tell us about that fan.
The fan that we use is a max fan. It's a multiple speed fan, so it's extremely efficient, not noisy, but it's also, the max fan come with a shell cover, so it can be operated even if it's under the rain, and it has an automatic function on it, so you can put it on automatic and it will maintain a normal temperature inside the RV. Even if you leave it and go to the fair, for example, you will come back and the speed of the fan will automatically adjust to move that hot air off the RV during your stay.
Great. And out here in the dinette area, I see we have a television.
Yep, it's on a sliding support, so you have it's always a smart 24-inch TV. that is available, so you can move it like that on the side to have a better view, and then you can push it back and it locks in place right there. Another nice thing about the RV is the fact that for the bathroom we're using those sliding doors. So one aspect of the sliding door is that you don't need to move out of the way to get into the bathroom. You can just open the door and you right away have access to it. Sometimes it's a tight van, so even if the panoramic feels bigger, and it is, I mean, there it is roomier, not only because of the window, but because of the way the things are shaped inside, and just do a step back and I can come back. So it makes a great spot to have more movement into the van. And also we have a curtain system that goes 360 degrees around the shower, but when I'm taking my shower, I don't need to close that that door. It can remain open, the curtain is enough, and then it leaves more room for my elbows as I'm taking my shower, instead of being restrained by the door itself.
Okay, so we have a wand-style shower, and we have some beautiful European-style lighting here that can be adjusted.
So you can see we have that huge window. It's an awning style window, so it opens from the bottom to create good ventilation, even if there is a rain outside. And then you have that big shade that comes down, closes, and we have some very nice reading lamps also that that can be adjusted like that and in position, and in order to get better light for reading.
And you have two of them.
Yep, two of those that you can slide anywhere on the track. Then we have an additional USB port there, and we have control for that upper light here. That track of light here is controlled there.
So you don't have to get up to adjust all your lights. There's switches and remotes different places.
Yeah.
Is that thermometer something you've added, or is that standard? That's
my uncle who added that to monitor the exterior and interior temperature.
Okay. And those we've got some storage up above.
Yeah, I don't know what's in there. Food.
You've been on the road.
Yeah.
Right, beautiful. Yeah. Okay, well, that's good, because open them both up, Phil. It shows just how much just how much stuff is in there.
Yeah.
Better than seeing empty boxes.
The skylight is great because it brings a lot of light inside, but it can also help for ventilation, as you can push it open. You can adjust it to different angles, but it brings a lot of air, and if you have flies, you can close that screen. And at night, you can always put the shade in place. And as you can see, it's extremely easy to operate. Yeah, so we have a very good size bed. It's a little bit under a queen. It's a 57 wide and 6 feet 2 inches long. So the same height that we have here, 6 feet 2 inches, we have the same length in the bed. And again, 57 wide, so a little more than a double bed. And the nice thing is that, you know, that bed sits a little high, which is great because it's a permanent bed, so it gives us a lot of cargo space under the bed, which we can access from the back or from this panel inside. But because of its height, we need to have some space, some elbow space to climb in the bed. So this is why here the space is wide enough to allow that. But in order to make it even easier, we've also added a little storage space at the bottom that can also be used as a step. So you can step on it and then you have easy access to the bed.
Go right up in the bed. That's great. What is the interior height in the unit?
6 feet 2 inches.
Okay, and how tall are you?
I'm 5'7".
Okay, 5'7". So you've got 8 or 9 inches there, easy.
Yep.
Yeah, that's great. A lot of headroom.
Yep.
Great. And over here we have
above the fridge is a cabinet where people can put a little toaster oven, or it can also fit a little microwave in there. Mm-hmm. So usually the user will choose
depending on what he prefers.
Okay, and over the bed is the Dometic AC. Is that 13,000 BTU?
That's a 13,500 BTU Dometic unit with the thermostat.
Right. Now, I'm afraid when we go out back, we're going to have a lot of noise. That's a bicycle rack and a clothes rack we see out the back.
Yeah, we have either a Fiamma or Thule bike rack at the back. We also have a Rolef mosquito screen that closes at the back, of course, shades everywhere. This unit here have an auxiliary television at the back and a DVD player.
So on this one, it looks like we sleep sideways.
Yep, absolutely.
Okay. I can give you a... Here's a simulated, okay. And how are those feet down there?
Yeah.
Good, still good, and look at these windows. That's my wife outside, and she's talking to Francois. You might have seen, that's Philip's uncle. You may have seen our video of the tour of prototype number 2 when we saw him at the beach. But you can see here, windows all the way around, and that's really, really the big selling feature of this unit. Yeah. One of the big selling features. How about we got some controls over here?
Yep, you have all the controls. For the light, control for the max fan, you have the control for the air conditioning, and a very important Truma control for the heating system and the water heater. And the Truma is a great system because in the Panoramic you have 5 air outlets that are across the vehicle. So you have some in front, some in the bathroom, some even in the cargo area. So the temperature is even all across the RV. Extremely precise heating system, but also extremely quiet. So this unit will run at night and you can hardly notice it's in function. So it's great for colder temperature.
Okay, great.
So if you need to have some big components or some you want to bring your bike inside the RV, it's possible to raise the bed now.
Yeah, well, we can do this. We can see it again from the outside, but it looks like underneath here we have a lot of storage. I see you could bring a bicycle. You could even bring a small motorcycle and maybe even a little ATV in there and turn it sideways. So it could be almost a modified toy hauler as well.
Yeah, I think that the best part is really that it's permanent, but sometimes you might need to lift it because, for example, if you're carrying carbon fiber bike at the back of the rack and you're leaving the RV for quite an extended period of time parked somewhere, you probably don't want to leave those expensive bike outside. So at least you have a place where you can raise the bed, snap that into position, and then you can bring your bikes inside.
Tell me about the front of the van.
Well, the ProMaster, one thing that is nice about the ProMaster, it comes with those OEM swivel seats. So these are not a standard seat with a swivel base. They are OEM from Dutch. So they provide an extremely great positioning for the driving or for the co-pilot. And they also provide great support if you're just in the lounge area. We also have another compartment here at the top, so that compartment is also there's a little light in there, but that provides a lot of storage, and that goes pretty deep for the whole cabin.
So these are ProMaster OEM seats.
Yep.
And they spin around, which makes this dinette perfectly usable. So you have this beautiful living space up here. Windows all the way around, and from here, how would we operate this table?
Yeah, I simply activate the knob and then we can turn it around. So if we want to have dinner side by side and look at the TV at the same time.
Let me interrupt for just one second. The TV is right here. Many of the units, including my little trailer, you can't access the TV from anywhere except the bedroom. So this is great. We can sit right here and see the TV as well as, again, these unbelievable windows.
Yep. And if we need more space, we can always push that table a little bit more in that direction. That swivel table can also use as an extended counter space if you want to prep
food. Yeah, so the food, this could also be more food prep areas. One of the things that I've noticed in many of these RVs, Phil, is that the food preparation space is very limited. And this continues all the way from the kitchen right on around. So probably has more than even up to some small Class A's. It's a fantastic feature.
Yeah, in fact, this is the layout of a Class A or a Class C, but combined into a much smaller RV. And this is what a lot of people are looking for, something that can move easy and quick to different destination, to visit parks and to do a lot of activities, but also to not, I mean, take a lot of space on the road, to be easy to drive. So it's but we kept that great layout into a smaller size.
And how long is the unit?
20 feet 8 inches, so let's say 21.
21, does that mean it can park in a regular parking space?
Well, I would say I do most of the time, and I would say that it's really easy to drive, and 21 feet is probably the longest that you can have without being overextended.
Obnoxious in your space, taking up too much space.
Exactly.
Yeah. So you don't have to go to your specific RV parking space. You can almost use regular parking spaces and regular lots. And you said you are a rock climber?
Yes.
Are you?
Rock and ice climber.
Ice climber? You get also. I mean the powder on the hands
for the
and
rock,
all
that? Yeah,
yeah, all that stuff? You got more guts than I do. That's for sure.
Well, it helps just disconnect from the job, you know, when I need to think about something else than RV, because I think RV days and night, but when I need to think of something else, when I'm on the rock, I can tell you that I only think about surviving.
Yes, yeah, surviving.
And staying on the rock.
Well, one of the things we haven't seen yet is the control panel before we go outside. So let's turn the camera around and we'll take a look at that.
So the control panel, everything is in a central location just above the sliding door. So you have access to, there are options of electrical or manual awning. This one is an electrical awning. So you have the switch for the awning. Then you have the different control for your level, battery level, fresh water, gray water, black water, and propane level. The switch for the water pump is there. Then you have your solar panel monitor, the inverter. There is a 2000 watt Samlex inverter on this RV, so it gives you a lot of power for all the electrical outlets. And then you have your master switch for propane and for electricity.
Okay.
Very simple. Our goal is really to give a better access to a great machine for people who wants to have that van life experience, you know. But to keep it into certain parameter and not to just explode pricing because we make a better quality. We don't want to just exploit that, the great design we have, you know.
Yeah, it's
fabulous.
It needs
to make sense. So we're going to open the back door and show you what's inside. So you have a huge cargo space in there with a bunch of drawers here where you can store a lot of equipment, but you can also flip the bed up like this. Keep it in a vertical position, it snaps in place, and then you can store your bike inside if you need to ever go away from the RV for a certain period of time.
So you can walk right through here?
Yeah, you can even remove that panel there and have a complete access on the ground.
That's great. close it now.
Wanted to close the, would you like to see the roll left door?
Sure, if you have time. So it not only rolls down, but it zips up so it doesn't blow.
Yep, and you can keep the flies away. But still bring a lot of ventilation inside the RV. You also have a mosquito door on the side and the sliding door, so you can leave all the doors open and have a great air circulation.
What's outside?
So outside we have a bike rack. So there's a Fiamma bike rack here. There is also a clothes dryer. So it can hold up two bikes for a maximum of 35 kilograms.
What is that in pounds?
70 pounds.
Okay. About wraps up the tour of this beautiful panoramic RV. You should definitely check these out. They're spectacular, and I'm sure they're going to be selling like crazy. If somebody wanted to find out some more information or order one, where would they go?
Well, they can visit our website, panoramicrv.com. They will find information, technical information, options, specification. You can always write us an email and we'll be very happy to quote your dream and get it ready for delivery.
Great. And the base price is around?
That will range between $110,000 to $135,000 US, depending on the option selection. Most people end up in the middle zone, I would say 120. Up to 125 with a fully loaded, a great RV and probably a better engineered and a better build quality than what you're used in this industry.
And are they manufactured in Canada or the U.S.?
Yeah, they are manufactured in Canada, but for all the U.S. market, we manufacture on a U.S. chassis. So we take care of all the logistic of bringing those chassis in Canada, manufacturing the RV, and then sending it back to the US. So you don't have any trouble. You get a fully US compliant
RV. Yeah, that's great. Thank you so much again for the tour. Hope you enjoyed this video. There's some other ones on the YouTube channel. You can actually see, as I mentioned before, the tour I did of Phil's uncle Francois over at the beach in prototype number 2. It's just slightly different than this one, but you can get a really great interior tour of that one. I'll put a link to that right here. And there's some other people that I've run into along the way that I've done tours of their units. You can see those as well. Thanks again. Until the next video, have a great afternoon. Thank you.